Welcome to my presentation about validation of deep convolutional generative adversarial networks for high-energy physics calorimeter simulations. I'm a PhD student from the University Aachen in Germany and work on my PhD here at CERN in Switzerland in the section CERN Open Lab. CERN Open Lab is a unique public-private partnership that works to accelerate the development of cutting-edge technology solutions. In particle physics, we study the fundamental properties and interactions of elementary particles. Therefore, we collide particles with the highest possible energies to produce other known and unknown particles. Calorimeters are one of the main components of high-energy physics detectors, which are responsible for measuring the energy of particles. Primary particles which enter the calorimeter create a shower of secondary particles. See for example in this image here. The primary particle is entering the calorimeter from here from the left, and the shower is evolving inside the calorimeter. The energy of the particles gets finally absorbed and sampled in the calorimeter. For our simulations, we use electromagnetic calorimeters, which measure the energy of electrons via electromagnetic interactions, which are mainly Bremsstrahlung and pair production. Calorimeter Monte Carlo simulations are based on GN4, which are very computing resource intensive. They use about 50% of the computational resources of the huge worldwide LHC grid. And in the future LHC high luminosity phase are around 100 times more simulated data needed. Even with taking the technology improvement into account, this exceeds the computational resources by a lot. That is why we are seeking and developing on faster approaches to replace the recent Monte Carlo simulations. A natural first step is nowadays to investigate deep learning algorithms, because they are known to work even better when more data is available and therefore they scale up well. But before we come up with a new simulation approach, let us first look at the simulation data on the next slide. We interpret the outputs of the calorimeter as images. One event, that means the measurement of the energy of one primary particle, creates one static three-dimensional shower with the dimensions 25 by 25 by 25 pixels. We have 200,000 shower images within a uniform energy range of 2 to 500 GeV. Here you can see schematically the 3D space of our calorimeter. The particle enters the calorimeter in the middle of the X and the Y axis. As it is hard to visualize three-dimensional images, I want to show you the green plane as cut out of the 3D space as an example shower image on the right. The primary particle is again entering in the middle of the x-axis, and the shower is evolving in the z-axis or in the depth of the calorimeter. The new simulation approach, which we use for replacing the GN4 simulations, are generative adversarial networks, or short GANs. Because our training data is three-dimensional, we name our model 3D-GAN. The whole GAN model consists out of two neural networks, the generator network, which generates the fake data, and a discriminator network, which gets as input the real data, the training data, which I showed you on the slide before, and the fake data from the generator. The discriminator outputs a real fake probability. The training is successful when the real fake probability is 50-50, and therefore the discriminator is no more able to distinguish between the real data and the fake data from the generator. In previous works, it's already shown that GANs reach a good level of accuracy. In this research, we created a new neural network architecture which speeds up inference. And we want to validate the GAN results with respect to Monte Carlo to see if the model are good enough to replace the recent Monte Carlo simulations. In the real application later, when we replace the recent Monte Carlo simulation, we only use the generator network. Therefore, all our studies on the following slides focus only on the generator network. As we have 3D images, the obvious first step was to use 3D convolutional layers to represent them. Here you can see the previous architecture, but I don't want to go into the details of the architecture. Just to mention, the input vector to our neural network is a latent vector with a size 200. And the output is our three-dimensional shower image with the dimensions 25 by 25 by 25. But convolutional 3D layers are computational demanding. And therefore we created a new neural network architecture consisting only of convolutional 2D layer, which I show you on the next slide. Again, I don't want to go into the details of the architecture, but with this architecture, with using three branches and some transposing, we are able to solve three-dimensional image problems with only two-dimensional convolutions. And additionally, with this transition, we reached a 1.3x speedup in the inference process compared to the previous convolutional 3D model. And with this, we reached already a huge 8,000 times speedup versus the Monte Carlo simulation, which we aim to replace. This high number highlights the potential of GAN simulations. With the transition from convolutional 3D to convolutional 2D, we also doubled the number of parameters in the neural network, which means that we expect also a higher physics accuracy. I will provide you a detailed evaluation of the physics accuracy of our GAN model on the next slides. It is known that image generation problems are hard to evaluate. We tried to come up with a single value validation matrix, which is calculated by the mean squared error of the two-dimensional projections of our shower images between the generated images and the validation data. The results for this are shown in the table here. As this is an error, the lower the value, the better is the accuracy. One can see that the MSE for our new convolutional 2D model is lower as the one for the convolutional 3D model, and therefore our new convolutional 2D model reaches a higher accuracy. On the right side, we can see the shower shape plots. If you look very detailed, one can see that the convolutional 2D model in green follows the GN4 simulation in red very closely, and that the convolutional 3D model in blue is at some pixels slightly off. This we can see, for example, if we look here, or here, or here. The second matrix which I want to introduce is the sampling fraction. It plots on the x-axis the input energy of the primary particle into the calorimeter, and on the y-axis the ratio of Ecal divided by the input energy. Ecal is simply the sum of all pixel entries of our image and corresponds to the total measured energy of the calorimeter. In this plot, we can see that for energies below 100 GeV, the convolutional 3D model performs worse, whereas the convolutional 2D model performs good for the full energy range. The third matrix, which we use for evaluating our GAN model, is the single cell energy response. The histogram shows how many cells of which energy level are contained. For creating this plot, we used 20,000 shower images from the full energy range. One can see that the description from the GAN models are not exact, in particular for small energies below 1 MeV. We have to perform additional searches to better understand this behavior. To mention here, the training of the 3D model was done by a former PhD student, and they never experienced that the cell energy deposition graph was so far off. I did the training for different models, including the shown convolutional 3D model, and was never able to completely reproduce the cell energy deposition diagram for low energies. So maybe I have somewhere a bug in my code, but until now I was not able to find it. With this, I only want to say that I doubt that the problem lies in the neural network architecture. And additionally, it should be noted that we applied a minimum energy threshold at 10 to the power of minus 6 GeV to take the detector resolution into account. The detector resolution is defined by double the electron mass, which is necessary for creating two photons in the pair production process of secondary particles. Below this energy threshold, the energy is mainly dissipated by ionization and excitation, and not anymore in the generation of other particles. The fourth matrix is the single pixel comparison. We compare the energy depositions of the single pixels of our three-dimensional images. We use intermediate particle energies of 250 GeV within a plus minus 2 GeV range and compared to Monte Carlo simulation. The results can be visually seen in the plots for the mean and the standard deviation on the right, and the averages are shown in the table on the left. The red line at the one level corresponds to the baseline Monte Carlo simulation to which we compare to. We can see that the convolutional 3D model in blue underestimates the mean cell energy deposition, whereas the convolutional 2D model in green shows a good representation. This we can see even better if we look at the average values in the table here. In the standard deviation, we can see that both GAM models underestimate the STD, the convolutional 3D model, even a bit more than the convolutional 2D model. And therefore, the convolutional 2D model performs better in this matrix. Understanding whether GANs can reproduce the same level of similarity exhibited by the original Monte Carlo dataset is essential in the context of scientific simulations. In order to better understand the level of similarity or diversity among the images, we measure the Structural Similarity Index, or short SSIM. We measure the index for random image pairs from the Monte Carlo data, labeled as Monte Carlo versus Monte Carlo, the GAN data, labeled as GAN versus GAN, for example here 2D versus 2D and 3D versus 3D, or between both datasets, Monte Carlo versus 2D and Monte Carlo versus 3D. Overall, we observe that the SSIM for the generated images versus the generated images of both GAN models in green and blue are clearly higher than the corresponding Monte Carlo value in red, indicating that on average, GAN images are more similar to each other than Monte Carlo images are. Or in other words, GAN fails to reproduce the image diversity present in the Monte Carlo sample. The convolutional 2D model does, however, perform better with a lower SSIM as the 3D model. It is also interesting to note that by measuring the similarity between GAN and Monte Carlo images in light blue and gray here, we can see that both GAN models produce images that resemble Monte Carlo within the same level of similarity as the Monte Carlo dataset itself in red. Okay, now I'm through all our physics validation metrics of our GAN models and want to summarize the results. With the transition from the previous convolutional 3D network to our new convolutional 2D network, we reached a 1.3x speedup. Compared to Monte Carlo simulation, the new convolutional 2D model reached even an 8,000 times speedup. And in general, both GAN models reach a very high physics accuracy and perform great. But when we look very detailed into our plots, we can see that overall the convolutional 2D model performs better. This is all I wanted to show to you. Thank you very much for your attention and for accepting our paper. And if you have questions, feel free to ask them now.